Hello students, I welcome you all again in new e-learning video in Let's Facilitate Learning classroom. Today we are going to study the sixth lesson Into the Wild written by Kiran Purandare. In this video we are going to learn only the first part of the lesson and the second part will be in the next video. Before starting the lesson, let's have a look on writer's information first. Kiran Purandare, born in 1961. After BCom, he studied environmental studies at Jordan Hill College of Education in Scotland. He is a recipient of many awards and honors like Sahitya Puraskar, Pune's Bhai Madhav Bagal Award and Best Literature Award given by the Cultural Department of Maharashtra for the book Sakha Nagazira. Actually, he is a wildlife expert, a bird watcher, a writer and honorary wildlife warden in Maharashtra. He is also founder of Nisargaved organization and Kikas Bird Club. Part 1, which is titled as Lost in the Jungle, has been taken from the book Sakha Nagazira, explaining amazing experiences of writers where he is alone and completely lost in the jungles of Umbarzara. Now let's study the meaning of the lesson paragraph wise. I am going to explain the meaning of the lesson paragraph wise, and the selected paragraph or the content is in the form of slide before you. Let's start now. Into the Wild, Part 1, Lost in the Jungle. The 8.5 hour long day inside the hide was as fruitful as Jamba tree standing tall on the edge of Umbarzara. Before wrapping up my day at this natural waterhole, I took entries of the avifauna in my field notes. Since I was alone, I rushed to Pitezhari village where I was stationed. I camouflaged the hide, took my essentials, came out of the hide and stretched out to my heart's content. I lifted my camera bag and took the familiar trail to Pitezhari. Negotiating the webbed leaves of teak wood and moha trees, trying to make minimal sound, I was treading cautiously among the woods. Walking alone in a jungle needs more alertness than walking with a companion. I was alone here like a fox, following the trail silently, watching with wide open eyes. My ears were grasping a variety of sounds just when a familiar sound stunned me. Khak, khak, khako, khak. Writer spent 8.5 hours in a hide in the jungle, which was on the edge of Umbarzara. Here, hide means a camouflaged shelter used to get a close view of wildlife. It is a place built to look like its surroundings. The writer used to observe birds and noting their behavior. If he was visible, the birds would not come near him or act in a natural manner. Hence, he had to build a hide, conceal himself in it, and then observe birds unnoticed. On that day, he wound up all the essential things with him, heading towards his pitezari where he lived. Jungle was quite dense, so he walked making minimum sound with alertness. It's clear that the writer was alone in the jungle where there were many wild animals. So he had to be watchful as a fox, because he was aware of the fact that he could be suddenly attacked by animals like leopards. He had to keep his eyes and ears open to save himself from wild animals who could catch him unaware. If he was not alert, the fox is an animal which is very cunning to save itself from the sudden dangers, and so the writer compares himself to a fox. After walking some distance or after walking some steps, writer stunned when he heard suddenly sound of langurs, a species of monkeys. Langur is the name of species of monkey. Second paragraph. It was a langur alarm call. The leader of the gang langurs was sitting on the tall tree making alarm calls out of fear for life. Rest of the langur brigade continued raising the alarm calls. The network of alarm calls was expanding its range as the petrified langurs speeded to the near trees and far and secured their places on treetops. All this upheaval was created by only one animal's presence, a leopard. Many animals make alarm calls when they see a predator, tiger or leopard nearby. The langur is the most reliable when it comes to finding clues about the presence of the apex predators in the jungle. The mighty elusive leopard of Umbar Zara was out of its lair. He was on the prowl. The stealthily moving figure in spotted gold-black cloak was spied by these langurs. Even the small ones from the legion of langurs were giving alarm calls, chak, chak. Writer heard alarm calls of langurs signifying the presence of apex predators. Here, tiger or leopards are called as apex predators. Writer immediately realized that the langurs are scared of their lives by the movement of one of these predator or animal. They started network of alarm calls. Langurs of all age groups raise alarms and caution their clan so that they can quickly secure their places on treetops far and near. Langurs alarm calls are supposed to be the most reliable sound to signify the presence of wild animal. The mighty elusive leopard of Umbar Zara was definitely out of its lair spotted by the langurs. Next paragraph. I stayed put, gawked the leader langur's target site and scanned the area visually. Took some steps, stopped again. A fresh Scat was lying before me on the trail. The bluish purple flies were hovering over it. I was sure that the leopard was somewhere near. The distant alarm call of four horned antelope was adding to the chaos. I barely walked around 15 meters and stopped. I had apparently entered in the sanctum sanctorum of a miracle called leopard, but the big cat was not visible. It is an elusive animal. The surroundings were reminding me that I was all alone time and again. As I moved forward on the trail to Pitezari, the fading alarm calls were still heard in the background. I could tell instinctively that the leopard had moved away. Writer focused to the direction of Langur's site and observed the area thoroughly. He found some clues like scat showing the presence of leopard on which bluish purple flies were hovering over it. Scat means dropping of animal. At that time, antelope's alarm calls also added chaos in it. Raito walked some steps and stopped and realized that he had entered in the sanctum sanctorum of leopard. Sanctum sanctorum here means territory, but the original meaning of this word is a place where few are allowed as secret or important work is done. The big cat was not visible as it is an elusive animal. Writer started heading the place Pitezari where he was stationed. Pitezari is the name of a village. Next paragraph. Meanwhile, I saw a man standing at a distance with a stick in his hand. As I approached, he appeared spooked due to the alarm calls of the leopard. We greeted each other. He was Raju Iskape from Pitezari. He had come to collect logs but retreated due to the leopard's movement. Raju was amazed at my regular solitary visits to Umbarzhara, the haven for tigers, leopards and sloth bears. We stopped under a kusum tree to take a break. We both felt a bit relaxed. Now we were four eyes, four hands with a stick. Then we both resumed our walking tour. There was one tiny track that broke out of the main trail. I will take this route, you go straight, said Raju and turned right. I kept walking straight until I climbed a familiar hillock. I crossed the cement pillar stones stacked by Forest Development Corporation to mark the boundary of the forest compartment. Meanwhile, writer saw a man at a distance. A stick was there in his hand when the writer reached near him. He was tremendously frightened. Spooked means frightened. As he also heard alarm calls. The person was Raju Iskape, villager of Pitezari, who used to come to jungle to collect piece of woods. Raju felt surprised seeing writer's solitary visits to Umbar Zahra, because Umbar Zahra was a refuge or home for tigers, leopards and sloth bears. After meeting Raju, the writer and Raju both felt relaxed, because now they were two of them to find their way out of jungle to face predators. After walking some distance, writer made a decision to go on a divided trail, while Raju turned right and went straight. The writer kept walking till he crossed Forest Development Corporation to mark the boundary of forest compartment. The writer select another trail and kept walking till he come across a beautiful mahua tree loaded with reddish brown leaves. Let's learn the next paragraph. Took another trail. After climbing down, walked across a beautiful mahua tree loaded with reddish brown leaves. The ground under the tree was cleaned very well. The thought instantly flashed in my mind, I had lost my way. Next moment, I found another dusky trail. Hastily, I took that trail, which took me from a narrow gorge to an open field. The area was surrounded by hillocks of dry, deciduous tropical forest. I turned back to spot the sun. Now the geographical west was set. The dusky trail had vanished. Good heavens, I was lost, completely lost in this jungle. That too at a very dreadful time. The sun was melting down like a fleeting runner. Now, the writer select another trail and kept walking till he come across a beautiful mahua tree loaded with reddish brown leaves. Suddenly, he realized that he had lost his way in the jungle, and that too in the evening. Soon, night was about to fall down. Now he was desperate to find a village and civilization. Next paragraph. Soaked in my own sweat, I felt like shouting to my heart's content, but there was no other soul to listen to my sound in this wilderness. I had two bags with me, the Shabnam bag having the camera, and the other was a small colorful handmade bag used in villages to carry tiffin. The tiffin still had some stuff, but I didn't feel like having it. The blossoming boxwood trees, the boop boop sound of cockle bird, the song of robin bird all appeared alien to me. Now writer failed to shout loudly to his heart's content, but there was no one to listen him. He had two bags, one of camera equipments and the other of tiffin. There was some stuff in the tiffin box, but writer didn't felt like having it. Even various sounds of birds appeared alien to him. Let's move to the next. It was more than an hour, and I was still there searching for a suitable tree to climb and get secured. Turn back to the trail you left, my mind was telling me. But there were no signs of the trail. I had no other way to climb the hillock before me. There were more hillocks and some more around the one I was standing. Near my feet were the dried up droppings of sloth bear. The sloth bear of Umbar Zara must be out in open sniffing for food, I cautioned myself. Thinking of averting all sorts of eventualities, I made my move and I ran down the hillock that I had climbed at a frantic speed. The west was to my right hand side now. The evening breeze flew through my wet, curled hair. My stomach was aching. I kept walking in hope. Writer was there for more than 1 hour. He searched a tree to climb for protection, but changed his mind and started climbing a small hill. There he found dried up droppings of sloth bear. Umbar Zara is the haven for sloth bears too. Thinking about all the dangers and risks, Writer climbed up one hillock on frantic speed, having terror in mind. Writer kept walking in hope. Let's move to the next. After around 50 steps, I found a bright red soil trail. I found my silver lining on this trail. There were marks of bicycle wheel on this trail. That was a big consolation for me. There must be a village nearby, I reassured myself. More questions resurfaced. How far is the village and where, in which direction? I climbed one more hillock and tried to locate signs of human civilization. My legs were trembling as I reached the top of the hill. I jumped with joy. I heard the sound of people talking in the loudspeaker. After around 50 steps, Writer found a bright red soil trail having silver lining on it. Silver lining means the mark of a bicycle on it, on the trail. Here the writer used beautiful term silver lining because it signifies a hopeful solution to an apparently difficult or gloomy situation. The writer lost his way in the deep jungle. He tried but had no clue how to reach the village. So when he saw a bright red soil track and the marks of bicycle wheels on the track, he was relieved that he must be close to human habitat. He was sure that the village was not far away, and that gave him assurance that he would be able to find his way towards the village. He climbed one more hillock and tried to locate signs of human civilization. After that, he jumped with joy. He heard the sound of people talking in the loudspeaker. Let's move to the next. In a jiffy, I ran down the hill towards the sound with full vigor. I stumbled and fell down, saw droppings of blue bulls nearby, struggled, stood up, and decided which direction to move on. The signs of civilization were visible. The tiny sleepy village of Pitezari was visible through the green woods. The lantern of Rajiram Bhalavi's farm, the loudspeaker installed for Keshav Bhalavi's marriage, all were in clear sight. Turn left to spot the village lake and familiar hillock Suihudaki. The dog barked to welcome me to the village. The first thing I did was to take a bath. The shaking of limbs had lessened a bit. The stomach's ache started again, ate to the full, and then slumped on to the cot. Lying awake, looking at the star-studded sky, I spoke to myself, there still exists a jungle where we can get lost. Isn't this our good luck? Taken from Sakha Nagzira. The writer jumped with joy, ran down the hill towards the sound, saw droppings of blue bulls nearby. Then he decided the direction and headed to it. The tiny sleepy village of Pitezari was visible through the green woods. He could hear the sound of people talking in the loudspeaker. The lantern of Rajiram Bhalavi's farm, where the loudspeaker was installed for Keshav Bhalavi's marriage. He could saw that clearly. Turned to his left to spot the village lake and familiar hillock, and finally reached to Pitezari. Feeling relieved, he thought of all the ordeal, spoke to himself, there still exists a jungle where we can get lost. Isn't this our good luck? Thus, the lesson ends. Human beings have tried to take over all the natural areas of the world. We have encroached on jungles and forests, and there are human inhabitations within the jungles too. To find a jungle where there is no sign of human life and one can still get lost shows that there are some areas untouched by humans and left to nature. That is what our good luck said by the writer. In this way, we have completed the first part of the lesson. We will meet in the next video with new information. Till then, stay motivated, stay awesome. Thank you.